You ready for this, Pierre?
I was born ready. A strong, a rugged, manly. Hey?
Let's do it then.
That's right.
Like a job for Mountie Pierre and Ranger Kent.
That's right. Show us your way, Bigfoot.
Ranger, we forgot to go on the rides.
No, we'll go on the rides later, Pierre, I promise.
Come on, Bigfoot. Friends of Bigfoot, we are here to cheer you up, eh?
What's wrong, everybody? Why so down?
I'm so terrified to go out there with all of those people. I know that I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm so afraid.
But ringleader, you're a leader. You're a motivator. You're supposed to be you're good to be out there and doing all those wonderful things. And strong man. You are very, very strong. Not as strong as me and rugged as me, but you're very strong, you know, eh?
I'm weak and useless and puny.
I'm ugly. No one will ever love me.
And dear lady, you know, you are very unique and you are very, very pretty and wonderful. Come on, you guys, you gotta get motivated, eh?
You're ugly and no one will ever love you.
No one will ever love me.
Your muscles are just flesh. You're puny and useless.
Puny and useless.
When you're on stage and no one laughs at you, you're a failure.
Devil. Look, Pierre, it's worse than I thought.
Yeah, look, you know, they didn't even put a tarp under that tent if it rains.
No, look at the spiritual eyes God gave you.
Oh, no, it's the Jersey Devil, that dirty rot.
What are you going to do about it, Pierre? So, what are you going to do? Run over me with your hobby horse? Look at you, you're pathetic. That hair, those pants.
Are you ready for your Bible verse of the day, Pierre?
Yeah, eh?
It's found in Romans 8. The Spirit himself testifies with our spirit that we are God's children. Now, if we are children, then we are heirs, heirs of God and co-heirs with Christ.
And you, little man. You can stand up at any time.
For though we live in the world, we do not wage war as the world does. The weapons we fight with are not the weapons of the world. On the contrary, they have divine power to demolish strongholds.
Look at you two. The two of you together. Tweedledee and Tweedledum-dum. You guys are pathetic together. As well as apart. You think you can take me?
I'm reading this morning from the book of Ephesians, the 6th chapter, the 10th verse. It says, "Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armor of God, so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground. And after you have done everything to stand, stand firm then, with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to this, take up the shield of faith, with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God."
Our Bibles!
Oh, they're back at the tent!
Let's get them!
No!
Lose him in the fair!
You know, it's a little bit of fair warfare, you know?
Let's go.
He is lucky. That devil is lucky he did not come. Because you know what? If he was behind me, if he wasn't behind me, if he was here now, then I would have gotten him. Why are we moving?
Hit him with the word, Pierre!
I hit him with the word!
I mean, read it to him!
I am ready.
The sons of Japheth, Gomer, Magog, Madai, Javan, Tobol. Get behind me, Satan! You are a stumbling block to me. You do not have to think to the mind of God, but the things of man.
Romans 8:37. We are more than conquerors through him who loves us, eh? Oh.
First Peter 3:3. Your beauty should not come from outward adornment, such as braided hair and the wearing of gold jewelry and fine clothes. Instead, it should be that of your inner self, the unfading beauty of a gentle, quiet spirit, which is of great worth in God's sight.
Philippians 4:13 says, I could do everything through him who gives me strength. Yeah!
We are children of the living God. You have no place here.
You are not welcome here, eh?
In the Bible are true for me and you.